Good morning, Dr. Atre. Dr. Tamilmani, I can see Anil there, other seniors, friend from Defense Forces, media, eminent scientists from India and abroad, and young students. The tone of my talk is already guided by three eminent speakers in the morning session. Honorable Raksha Mantri Ji, SA2RM, and Chief of Air Staff. They talked about indigenous capabilities, they talked about indigenization, and also they talked about the role of Indian industry in ensuring an optimized defense preparedness for the country. It is in this reference that next 30 minutes and 30 slides, I talk to you about the role and vision of HAL in the defense preparedness of this country. HAL, which is a 70 years old company, is basically the trust of Indian people in the creation of aerospace capabilities in India. India 2012, the present. We are the largest democracy with second largest workforce. We are sixth in patents and ninth in nuclear power reactors. Today we are the fourth largest economy. And by 2020, we aspire to be the third largest economy of the world. When we aspire for India 2020, there will be challenges. Economic challenges, where we have to ensure a higher GDP growth and also ensure a financial inclusion for every citizen of the country. There are challenges in internal front, and there are challenges which are external to us. If we look at our neighbors, we find that most of our neighbors are high, in fact highest, at the risk of failures. In fact, 25 of the 60 states are located in Asia. We have a coastline, 7,000 kilometers plus, and 15,000 kilometers of the land border. This leads to us to think of our defense imperatives in larger details and on a prioritized basis. What is HAL doing today to support our defense forces? We are into fighters, trainers, helicopters, aerospace, civil domain, and systems. We handle right from design, production, MROs, and through the life support. I am proud to say that we contribute a large chunk of the equipments which our defense forces are using in aerospace. While we provide 100% support to Indian Army, we also provide trainers, transport and fighter aircrafts and helicopters to Indian Air Force and Indian Navy. Not only this, all the satellite structures launched by ISRO till date have been made by HAL. We have also designed and developed first airworthy turbojet engine in India and have supplied structures for nation's Mars orbiter mission. This is what we do today. As a leading aerospace company and country's flagship company in aerospace, we are aware of our responsibilities of self-reliance, which is a key driver in HAL's philosophy. And as you will see on this drawing, in our major programs, we have already achieved a level of 60% to 80% of indigenization. Not only this, we have a target where we develop new vendors for indigenous capabilities. As on date, we have a registered vendor base of 2,215 industry partners with us who are contributing about 25 lakhs of standard man hours. This is the extent of indigenization which we have promoted. Our performance 2012, physical performance, we deliver to the country every week one aircraft. In financial terms, HAL was started with equity capital of 120 crore. And last year alone, we have paid 700% dividend to the government. Our contribution to national exchequer is to the tune of 2,000 crore plus every year. And this time, we plan to increase it further. In order to prepare ourselves for 2020, customers are important and suppliers are important. And that is why few months back we took an initiative known as Customer Connect, where 50 top people of the company went and stayed at the base camps of our customers. Similarly, we started a campaign where we deal with our vendors and suppliers and business partners, and they tell us what are the systems we should change and what are the procedures which we should adopt new. We have also started various strategic achievements. When we talk of India and civil aerospace, it is a known fact that countries develop capabilities in defense segment. And if they are intelligent, they leverage this knowledge into civil segment. This is what will be the vision of HAL for next 7 years. Where are we in civil aerospace? CAGR of 14%. Air traffic to double in next 5 to 7 years, and in 2020, approximately 35 crore Indians will be traveling in aircrafts. India will be the third largest aviation market in the world. Are we ready for it? Till now, as far as Indian civil aerospace efforts are concerned, HAL has been leading it with Avro 748. We have supplied 89 of them to Indian Air Force and 22 to our civil users. Dornier. Today, we are the only country in the world who are fully supporting the entire range of Dorniers. They are being used by Indian Navy, Indian Air Force, Indian Coast Guard, and also 14 users in the civil sector. Not only this, when we manufacture Dornier, we also contribute to the friendly relations of India with other countries. 31st January was a red letter day when our Honorable Raksha Mantri Ji offered one Dornier aircraft to the Foreign Minister of Seychelles. We look forward for such more opportunities and contribute towards India's foreign relations. India's own product, Advanced Light Helicopter. We have already produced and offered 148 of them, and next few years we will be offering 124 more. Apart from defense forces, we have exported 10 of them to Nepal, Mauritius and Ecuador, and 12 of them are being used by domestic users like ONGC, BSF, National Geography Survey, etc. Light utility helicopter. This is one which Dr. Saraswat also spoke about in the morning. India basically is a helicopter country. Today we have 280 helicopters out of total world population of 35,000 plus. That means less than 1%. With 15% of the world population, we deserve to have at least 10,000 helicopters. There is a need that we have 600 district centers which need to be connected from law and order and national disaster management point of view. LUH, where design and configuration is already frozen and is being made as compliant to FAR 27, will be an answer to the country's need for light transport. MRO industry. We have today 430 plus aircrafts, and normally MRO will be 15% of the operating cost. We expect a MRO size of 7,000 crore by the year 2020. We as a country have a potential to be a MRO hub due to growing aircraft fleet and locational advantage and availability of cost-effective talent. HAL over the last 70 years has adequate infrastructure for military MROs. We have established our own quality systems and logistic frameworks. We have experienced workforce with necessary skill set. We had one operational airport at Bangalore, and in 2 days, DGCA of the country is going to give us the license papers for starting another airport at Ojar, that is Nasik. To sum up, India as well as HAL is at a unique advantage point from civil aircraft MRO point of view. When we talk of serving the Arab countries and Southeast countries, India will have a strategic advantage of serving as a MRO hub. And in India, with two fully functional airports at Bangalore and Nasik, and also an airstrip at Kanpur, HAL will be in a position not to service only the military aircrafts, but also the civil aircrafts. What will be HAL's role in India 2020? I am sure, as a leader of Team HAL, we have a central role to play for strengthening India's economic and security situation. We will have two key strategies. Number one, increase thrust on indigenization and develop the platforms for the security issues which will emerge in 2020. We need to develop and strengthen 12 platforms. Out of them, 8 will be in fixed wing and 4 will be in rotary wing. Fifth generation fighter aircraft. The preliminary design phase has already started. It is a co-development project with Russians. The phase has started in February 2011. And next 1 month, we will be closing this phase. And then R&D phase starts in June 13. FGFA is what Honorable Raksha Mantri ji says, that we all players within India have to be in an integrative role. It's a project where DARE, LRD, BDL, AD, DABL, AD, RD, and many other universities and institutions will be working together. We have also embarked upon development of multi-role transport aircraft in category of 15 to 20 ton. We have already formed a JV with UAC of Russia. The preliminary design phase has already started in October 2012, and detailed design phase will be starting in November 2013, which will be a phase of 21 months duration. MMRC. An excellent opportunity for the Indian industry, where we'll be mastering and will be exposed to various technologies. The industry is happy, the defense forces are happy, but even in indigenizing it, there will be challenges. The challenge for the industry is that the TOT and the supplies from Dassault, Snecma, Thales, and 70 plus French OEMs is to be successfully transferred in a time-bound manner to 20 plus Indian production agencies. HAL has been assigned the role of lead integrator, and we are sure that we will be able to form a consortium including private sector where we make sure that this technology transfer to the country takes place in the most efficient manner. We will be third largest aviation hub. Our defense procurements go for $100 billion in next few years. But what are we doing on national civil aircraft project? We recently made a presentation to Planning Commission where we said we have so many islands of excellence in the country. We have NAL, we have ADA, we have so many other people. And it's a time when country should have its own national civil aircraft. It is agreed that HAL will be the lead partner along with NAL in a joint venture to be explored, and this national civil aircraft should be available with the country in next 6 to 7 years. We are envisaging an investment of something like 7,500 crore, where 4,300 crore will go in design and 3,200 crore goes into the prototype productions. LCA. You have seen in the morning how proud we are of this project and how hard we are working. More than 2,000 flights already done, 14 aircrafts flying today, and ADA's commitment to meet IOC by June 13. And it is now comes the turn of HAL, that after this certification is done, HAL organizes into an efficient manufacturing organization. But will that be easy? Number one. Number two, past few years, I have been witnessing an interesting debate in the country, where public sector says we are efficient, private sector will not have resources and infrastructure. Private sector says we are efficient and PSUs are only retarding the progress. Can we really do it in isolation? The answer is no. It is PSUs and it is private sector who together will join the hands, and we can succeed only if we two are together. This slide shows you as LCA is not only an excellent example of cooperation between PSUs and private sector, it's also conveying to us, if you look at the location of the companies who are contributing on LCA, it is the best integrative project for the country. But there will be challenges of coordination and manufacturing qualities. My worry today is, by the time when we enter into IOC, we would have seen many of these manufacturers already vanishing. As a manufacturing agency who has to deliver the products with the quality, the challenges for HAL will be enormous, and that is where we are preparing today. Su-30s. It is going to be our star fleet for Indian Air Force. We have already delivered 122 of these and 100 more to follow in the next years. That means total strength becoming 272. We have already achieved a high level of indigenization. There are 157 vendors who are already contributing us with 13,350 components. And we have adopted a new model. It's not that they will be located at isolated places. We have offered them, you come and settle in Nasik. You come in our township, we give you the sheds, we give you electricity, we give you water. And we also give you an offer for ready-made product on long-term basis. This is how we are developing the Indian industry and Indian vendors. Intermediate jet trainer, yes. There have been delays. And Honorable RM has given this as the foremost task to the team HAL to complete it now in time. IJT, total flights 647. Out of them, last year only we have done 185 flights. In the month of January, we have done 25 flights. That shows our focus is on IJT, and our friends in Indian Air Force are fully supportive of it. In parallel to this, we already started creating the infrastructure facilities at Kanpur Division, and our target is to achieve the IOC for IJT in 13-14, and our internal target is December 2013. In fact, only 2 days back, when Dr. Tamil Mani handed over that IOC of Rudra, the ALH weaponized version, I requested him, please come once more to HAL in December and this time to hand over a IOC on IJT. I am sure, sir, together whatever thinking, we will be able to do it. HAL's UAV experience, where are we today? We have designed and productionized PTAE, 35 numbers of PTAs already supplied. System level competence and UAV avionics test facilities for searcher and herons. But what is more important is, last 2 months, we have made a dedicated group for UAVs. We had discussions at the level of Home Secretary of India, where not only we will be supporting the paramilitary forces in UAV endeavors, we will also be developing and in fact presenting to him next month a national plan for UAVs by which the internal and threats could be taken care and also the cross-border terrorism. UAVs will be one area where you will see a lot of activities from HAL and other basically cooperative vendors with us in the times to come. February 3 was a pride moment, not only for HAL, but also for the defense forces, also for the certifying forces. On this date, we received the IOC for our weaponized version of ALH, that is Rudra, with turret guns, rockets, air missiles, flare and chef dispenser and helmet pointing systems. The first two models of this will be handed over to Indian Army. Deputy Chief of Army Staff will be here in Aero India, and 8th will be the day when we hand over these two products to him. It will be really a proud moment, not only for HAL, but it is a long wait of many years when we are able to produce something which is indigenous and is of our own. These are some photographs of Rudra into rocket firing, countermeasure dispensing systems, air-to-air missile firing. Light combat helicopter. There will be two technology demonstrators, this time in flying displays in Aero India. The TD-1 and TD-2 respectively have already completed 86 and 83 flights, and we are targeting for a IOC for LCH in September 2014. STT-40, the ab initio trainer with indigenous design, the metal cutting, was launched on 22nd August 2012, and its full-scale mock-up will be available for you to see during Aero India this time. Indian multi-role helicopter in 12.5-ton category, conceptually being developed in association with the defense forces, and possibly by next year we will be able to freeze entire thing on this. We talked about offsets. We had an opportunity of 20,000 crore last 5 years. And next 5 years, it will be an offset opportunity of 1 lakh crore. But are we really ready for it? In past, we have seen the very purpose of offset is to build indigenous capabilities, to decide on the technologies which this country will have. We have seen aberrations, and we have seen that even the hosiery suppliers and also the refrigerator makers have got away with the offset advantage. And that is why the government revised the offset policies in August 2012. There are many countries who have mastered this art of offsets, like Turkey, South Korea, Saudi Arabia, and Brazil. In fact, we have a specialized group who works only on offset. And what I am told is, there are countries who tell that, okay, we'll buy your product. You bring any technology, whatever you want, in our country. But we'll give you an offset advantage only when you have exported 30% of this to other countries. Even before a RFP is issued, the country decides what kind of technology I want for my defense forces, for my DRDOs and other industry. In offsets, opportunity is huge, so are the challenges. And that is why we are proposing is a India mission on offsets, which will be led by HAL, where all the industry partners will be there. And we propose the national policies and the kind of things which should happen in offsets with a focus on relevant technologies, capability development, and the offsets have to be performance driven. Global aerospace industries, some pondering points. As I already told, that it is your capabilities in the military segment which need to be translated to civil aviation. That is one. What is really happening world over? If you look at the distribution of manufacturing facilities, you will find that consumer goods like TVs, automotives, many of them will be located in low-cost countries. But when it comes to aerospace, they will be mostly located in high-cost countries. This technology will not be readily available because countries view this as a strategic military advantage. Even today, the developed countries are often perceived protecting their homegrown aerospace industry through export restrictions and various subsidies and favoritism in acquisitions. We propose the following. For India 2020, 5 points. Number one, a national aeronautics policy, an apex body who will decide who will develop what and who will collaborate with which organizations. That is what in the morning session Honorable Raksha Mantri Ji was also telling, that we need to have a cohesion among the various players like NAL, HAL, ADA and so many other laboratories. Yes, certification organizations like DGCA, DGAQA, they will need strengthening in terms of manpower and in terms of infrastructure. They are the people who are already under a lot of pressure. I am sure neither PSUs alone will do well, nor private sector. It's a time for synergy. It's a time that whatever models we adopted in our national infrastructure projects like building highways and other sectors, it's a time for a public-private partnership in the defense sector. If we want to enter into MROs, if we want to enter into civil aerospace, we'll have to declare the aerospace industry as an infrastructure industry status, and for that special aerospace economic zones, they need to be created. Industrial participation in perspective planning. There are two kind of approaches which countries adopt world over. Approach one, it will be the defense forces who will select which technology and then pass on to the Indian industry. Approach two, it is Indian industry who goes and presents their capabilities. Organizations like DRDO will go and tell, this is what is my R&D potential. And based on that, we decide on our acquisition policy. There are plus and minuses in both, but we'll have to adopt a policy where industrial participation in the perspective planning possibly will be more and more in times to come. Just last two slides. This is what, when I was a young engineer in ONGC, the late Prime Minister of India said, and it is still true today, a nation's strength ultimately consists in what it can do of its own and not on what it can borrow from others. You witnessed the Republic Day parade this year. We showcased four products: Pilatus, C-130, Embraer, and Agusta Westland helicopter. In these four products, neither DRDO has contributed, nor NAL has contributed, nor HAL has contributed, or for that matter, Indian industry has contributed. Yes, these four products are class apart. They are very, very good products, and I am sure they will do a great service for India. The challenge will be to master these star products, to master the technologies, and when, as a retired senior citizen of this country in 2020, I see the 26th Republic Parade, this is what is our vision to see: Indian products, Indian technologies, and Indian capabilities. Thank you very much. Jai Hind.
Thank you, Dr. Tyagi, for giving us an overview of what HAL has achieved to date and what is on the in the offing and what your perceptions are. Generally, the plenary speakers don't have any question and answer situation. But however, seeing that there are a number of students and futurists, I will allow about a couple of questions. More than questions, comments on what Dr. Tyagi talked about. It's open. Just 2 minutes, two questions.
Sir, may I make one request to you? I'll just take one question, and rest of the questions to me can be addressed at chairman@halindia.com.
Okay.
Reason being, sir, this SAP India is having a seminar at 12:15. Where HAL will be receiving 3 awards.
Oh.
So I must leave and go and receive those awards on behalf of Team HAL.
All right. With that case, then I must thank you. One question will allow.
One question from a young
One question, a comment. Anybody?
Preferably a student. Yes, please.
Yeah, quickly.
We will be violating a IPR if it is against the wishes of the person who is giving a technology transfer. Like in a project like MMRCA, what will happen? The technology will be transferred, and it will be a legal transfer where the OEMs, where the manufacturers will be passing on the know and how to us. So there would be no violations. And if I take further liberties, the dividing line in definitions of IPRs is very, very small. It depends on national interest and national strategy. Like I know one country, everything which they have today is reverse engineering. They said IPRs, we don't understand what it is. I'm not saying that we will do it, but the answer to you is, number one, develop your own technology. Develop your own products, number one. Number two, there are a lot of adaptive technologies which are available, and our friends in DRDO are doing a great job in that. I am sure IPR will not come in a way when agencies like DRDO and HAL work together and develop the products. Does this answer satisfy you?
Yeah. Anyway, that's okay. Thank you, Dr.
So I'll take leave, sir. Thank you very much.